Bread has joined the list of goods in short supply, causing its price to spiral beyond the reach of many Zimbabweans. Now many are becoming accustomed to having tea, a favorite morning beverage, without the bread. Gibson Nema now sells bread substitutes.
Now sometimes we have our thick porridge, sweet potatoes, green mealies. If we can get bread once a week, that will be it. But we no longer miss it because it is now expensive. If the government would push the price of bread and flour down, that would go well with our way of living. We have no cash. If it remains expensive, I will not be able to buy dinner if I buy bread.
While business is booming for vendors like Nema, these are very tough times for those who sell bread.
There used to be lots of bread, but these days people no longer buy like they used to do because prices are going high. We used to sell this bread for about $1, now it costs about $2.50, so people cannot afford it.
Minister of Industries Mangaliso Ndlovu recently said he found a company that could make bread using local ingredients to help ease the shortage and control price. But farmers say they do not have the infrastructure to produce wheat in a cost-effective way. They are calling on President Emmerson Mnangagwa's government to help.
Irrigation infrastructure and obviously the impact of land reform has had its impact on wheat production. It got down to a very low level at one point. It's come up, but for it to grow on a sustainable basis, the bottom line is farmers need a decent price and millers need to cover their costs and contractors need to be able to get the supplies that they need at affordable prices.
As government and industry officials search for a solution, Zimbabweans like Gibson Nema keep thinking of alternatives for something as basic as their daily bread. Columbus Mavunga for VOA News, Harare.